please stand and join me in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the playing of the national anthem. Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Altamaha EMC would like to congratulate the graduates of East Lawrence High School. Congratulations, Falcons. Continue to soar high from everyone at Altamaha EMC. With a location at 679 Ed Beckham Road in East Dublin and proudly rooted in the communities we serve since 1936. That's Altamaha EMC.
That moment that you're just trying to find, I just want somebody to understand me.
Right.
Even if we don't even understand at that moment, we're going to connect them to where they need to be.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I love about our team. And we want the community to know that. We want to emphasize the fact that, you know, no matter where you are in your life, no matter how far you feel like you're too far gone or there's no one that can help me, no one understands me. You know, someone told me they understood me and I told them and they looked at me crazy. We want to provide that sense of hope that, you know what, I'm here and I'm listening.
Right.
We want that atmosphere, you know, to be created when that first experience, when they walk in our front door, that they have the biggest smile from our receptionist to the EMF, to the clinician.
Yeah,
you know,
right.
We
that's
want right. that. And that is what we thrive on. That's what we strive to do. And I feel like we have made a big impact.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We have made a big impact because we meet them right where they are. We're embedded in the community.
Right.
It's a community service. So if that family who's struggling with finding resources to help with her life, his or her light bill, or clothing banks,
mm-hmm.
our staff are equipped with the knowledge, the tools,
yes.
and say, hey, mom, this is a resource for you. If you're struggling, let me help you. Let me show you. Let me go with you to show you how to make that connection.
Mm-hmm.
So even when you step down from services with us, you know where to go.
Right.
If you need something,
absolutely.
You know where to go, how to go, what to say. And I love it because we all offer teachable moments.
Right.
It's so amazing, like the work that we do and what we have to offer. And above all else, we meet them right where they are.
Welcome to the 2023 commencement of East Lawrence High School. I would like to thank all of our parents, family, and friends for your love and constant support, and to the members of East Lawrence High School faculty and staff for your guidance and patience. The Lawrence County Board of Education members, thank you for all your support of our school and our accomplishments. As students at East Lawrence High School, we are given the opportunity to succeed and to shine. Each member of our class has unique gifts that will only improve as we move on to the next phase of our lives. High school has been an unforgettable journey that has prepared us for the future, whatever it may hold. As Dr. Seuss said, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting. Go get on your way. Hello, my name is Jesse Norris. I would like to first thank all of the important people who are here for this special day. Thank you to our superintendent, Mr. Garnto, the school board members, teachers, and all of those amazing families here to support us. Without all of the parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins, and friends sitting in the audience today, we would not be walking across that stage tonight. So graduates, make sure to give them an extra big hug and a special thank you. As salutatorian, I was asked to speak on the past. The past is one of my least favorite topics, and because of that, it was hard to find a word to describe it. Inspiring, challenging, intricate, and crucial all came to mind, but none of that felt quite right. Through all of my brainstorming, one word kept coming to mind. And I know it is a strong word, one we were all taught not to say, but it was the only word that felt strong enough to describe how I truly feel about the past. So I will be honest with you, I hate the past. I hate the way it hurt me, and I hate the way it made me laugh. I hate the things I went through, good and bad. I hate the excitement I felt on the first day of school. I hate how we all used to be friends. I hate how we all used to be able to talk to anyone at school like we were best friends. I hate my friends for making me miss the school trips that we stayed up and played poker on. I hate my teachers for making me miss their words of encouragement and inside jokes we shared. I hate my advisors for making me miss all of the clubs I'm leaving behind. I hate the underclassmen for making me miss their jokes and smiles in the hallway. I hate the stupid old school that holds so many good memories. But most of all, I hate the way I don't hate it, not even close, not even a little bit, not even at all. I love my memories, but sometimes it's easier to hate them. But no matter my love for the past, it is gone. We will never walk the halls of East Lawrence as a student again. We will never be able to complain about the lunch food. We will never be able to sit in our cars after school and talk until they make us leave. We will never have a high school game, match, or meeting again. We will never be able to go to our senior or junior prom again. We will never be dress coded for our ripped jeans. When I was told to speak about the past, I was mad, because how depressing is that? It's like the loss of a friend. The love stays, but they are gone. It's hard to accept that harsh reality. But then someone asked me what I would do to change my past. My mind went blank. Although I hate the past and all it makes me feel, I wouldn't change a thing. Everything that happened in my past was for a reason. Everything I've been through, all the beautiful, terrible moments made me who I am. Throughout high school, I looked at the negative. I've obsessed, worried, and dreaded going to school. I've hated people, hated myself. I thought it would be easy to leave it all behind. I thought it would be easier to not feel anything to avoid loss. But now I see that I wasted 4 years of my life. I've wasted my time worrying about grades, friends, and everything else. I thought when I stood up here in front of you, it would all be worth it. It wasn't. I was running to the end of a race I didn't want to finish. Being second in my class is an honor, but one I would gladly give up for those years back. I say all of this to say, enjoy the next part of your life. Don't hate the memories. Don't hate the past. Don't worry about it. Don't wish you could have done something different. Love your past. It makes you, you. I'm no expert and certainly not one to give advice on how to not hate the past. It is something I struggle with every day. Ms. Lawrence told me I could add something about how to cope with the hate the past brings, if I felt that I could. Well, the short answer is I can't. I personally cannot provide a way to avoid coping with hate. So I turn to the Bible, James chapter 1, verse 5. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask God, who gives generously to all without reproach, and it will be given to him. I wish I had some other advice, but I would not be doing you a service. The best advice I can give is to read the word and put your faith in Jesus Christ. He has helped me more than I can ever tell you. It is so easy to feel anger. For me, that is a surface level emotion. I would rather point fingers than be honest with myself. I would rather pretend I don't care about anything or anyone. I would rather avoid the truth to avoid the hurt it brings. And the truth is, I love every single one of you. I've gotten to know most of you, and I will forever hate you for making me miss you so much. Please go out and enjoy your life. Stop trying to please others. Be compassionate, be kind, be free, do something great. We only have one chance to make our mark. I know each of you has unlimited potential. Don't waste it on anything less than extraordinary. Meet extraordinary people that make you feel like you're home and make you hate to leave. Traditionally, people thank everyone at the beginning of their speech, but I don't want to thank anyone. Instead, I want to make sure they know just how hard they are making this on me. It is all their fault I'm up here, and all their fault that it is this hard to let go. I want my parents to know that if they hadn't pushed me, I would have never stepped foot up here. Without their guidance, I would not have the drive and dedication I have today. I want my twin sister to know that without her, I would have hated coming to school. She is my built-in best friend. She is the Fred to my George. And without her, I would be valedictorian. So thank you, Jamie. I want Grandma to know it is her fault that I'm so ambitious, because she always made sure I knew that I could do anything I set my mind to. I want Landon to know it is his fault that I will miss all the school trips and long hours of playing poker. I want Dawson to know it is his fault I remember a million useless videos with a smile. I want Daniel to know it is his fault I know so much about kindness and selflessness. I want my fellow Woodardites to know that it is their fault I will miss TSA trips so much. I want Mason to know he is my best friend and toughest opponent. He has made me better in so many ways. And so of so many others that I could list, I could tell a story about each and every one of you, and I would mean every word. Without all those wonderful people, I would not be standing up here today. I love all of you, and I hate every single one of you for making this so hard. If it wasn't for you, graduating would be easy. I look out into the graduating class, and I see all the faces I've grown up with. I see memories, stories, and heartbreaks. High school is over, now on to bigger and better things. The future is bright for everyone sitting on this field. It is time to go off to college or the workforce and make new memories. We will make new friends, face new challenges, and achieve new heights. But no matter how high we fly, we will always remain a Falcon. And man, it's a great day to be a Falcon. Woo! Good evening, everyone. I am Jamie Norris, for those of you who don't know me. You might be feeling a little bit of deja vu right now, but don't worry, that's normal. We get it a lot. I would just like to start by giving a little shout out to Jesse. I hate that I have to follow that speech. I definitely cried a little bit. I would like to warn everyone that I'm not as eloquent as my sister, so please bear with me. I want to take a quick moment to thank everyone who is here for me today. My parents, Tori and James Norris, my grandmother, Melinda Bolino, one of my greatest supporters, Chan Knowles, and anyone else who came to support me on this big day. Now, real fast, before I get into the meat of my speech, I need to explain how I came to be in front of you today. First and foremost, I would not be where I am today without my parents. My mom is a primary school teacher, and I attribute my love of books and learning to her. She is also one of the only ones who will watch Pride and Prejudice with me as many times as I want. My mom has always been the one who assured me that my best effort was enough for her. She is constantly assuring me that she is proud of me even when I am not proud of myself. My dad will let me explain it this way. In the movies The Incredibles 2, Mr. Incredible is trying to help his son with math homework. He's yelling about how math is math and it doesn't matter if you do it the old way. I'm sure a lot of you parents can relate to that sentiment. It's like someone took a video of the two of us and animated it specifically for that movie. But he really did understand the math and anything else he put in front of him. He helped push me to be the best I can be while at the same time being proud of who I was. My grandparents have played a huge role in my life. Each and every one of my grandparents has made me the person that I am today. While all of them are not here with me physically, they will always be with me spiritually. One grandparent is today, and that's my grandma. She has done so much for Jesse and me. She is another reason I have a love of learning. She is also the reason I know how to write in cursive and love movies like Hook, Halloween Town, Twitches, The Santa Claus, and so many more. Oh, sorry. Another huge reason of why I'm up here is because of Jesse Norris, our salutatorian. She is my twin sister, and so that makes her my built-in best friend, like she said earlier. We've done all our first togethers, first steps, first words, first day of school, first day of dual enrollment. We are truly two halves of a whole, and I don't think I could have made it this far without her. And again, like she said, she's the George to my Fred, she's the Zach to my Cody, the Mary-Kate to my Ashley, and the Dipper to my Mabel. I can't wait for another first with you at UGA. Now, my topic, so to speak, was the future. And I'll get there, but I have to start with the past to make it to the future. August 6, 2019 was my first day of school. I remember walking down the halls of the old school and being terrified. There were so many people walking through the halls at one time, it felt so overwhelming. I was very nervous about my upcoming high school years. However, my friends helped me realize that we were all nervous, but we were all in it together. I want to thank the Woodardites, as Coach Fleming calls us, for being there for me. For those of you who don't know, that includes Mason Lloyd, Dawson Hobbs, Daniel Hobbs, Jesse, and me. Fleming always said that wherever Mr. Woodard was, we were not far behind. Dawson and Daniel are our honorary brothers. In fact, many people at school still believe we are quadruplets to this day. Besides good friends, there is one thing that made me feel very excited for my high school career, clubs. Skills USA and Beta are two of my favorite clubs, or organizations, as our president of skills, Landon, would say. They have shaped me into the person I am today, and as a ninth grader, I never would have been able to stand up here in front of you and speak. Ninth grade was an adjustment, but I adapted and kept going. Then COVID happened. I got used to it and kept going. Then we got to come back to school with new restrictions, so I got used to it and kept going. Then in 11th grade, we started dual enrollment, and I got used to it and kept going. At the beginning of this year, I had to become a senior and deal with being away from one of my best friends. I got used to it and kept going. I kept going and going and going and going. But recently, I had a moment when it was hard to keep going. I was so overwhelmed with school, extracurricular activities, work, and sports. At times, I wanted to graduate and be done with it all. However, right in the middle of my pity party, I got some news. I heard that Ben Brantley, last year's salutatorian, found out he had cancer. I was not super close to Ben, but the news hit me hard. I felt so terrible for having the audacity to feel sorry for myself. Ben came and spoke at a JKL meeting, and all he spoke about was positivity. He was so excited to be married and alive. He was already thinking about remission. After hearing him talk, it made me search for the positive things in my own life. I challenge you to adopt the same mindset. Take graduating, for example. We could look at it as the end of something great, distance from old friends, growing up too fast and changing too quickly. Or we could look at it as the beginning of something greater, finding more friends, growing wiser, and changing for the better. That is my same message to you today. No matter what you are going through, enjoy it. Make the most out of it. Sometimes that can be hard, but I have found that the truest form of joy comes from prayer. Lean on God and everything else will fall into place. James 1, 2 through 3 says, "My brethren, count it all in joy when you fall into various trials. When you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience." I chose this verse over all others because it explains so well what I'm talking about. We need to remember that even our trials are significant. They shape us into who we are. So when you're in the middle of your trials, look for the bright side. For me, that bright side includes the people in my life. That includes the amazing teachers who have helped me grow my love of learning. Teachers like Ms. Strickland, Ms. Clardy, Mr. Rowe, Mr. Woodard, to name a few. That also includes the important people in my life, the ones I named earlier. My family and friends helped me realize that there is something to always be happy about. I did not slow down enough and enjoy my high school career. Maybe you didn't either, but we have the opportunity to slow down and enjoy the rest of our lives. Wherever you go, whatever you're doing, be positive. Don't waste what little time you have dwelling on the negative. Sadness is not always a choice, but happiness is. Choose it. Focus more on the people in your life because they are the light in this dark world. I'll leave you with this quote by Dumbledore from Harry Potter. "But you know, happiness can be found, even in the darkest of times, if only one remembers to turn out the light." Thank you.
Ready for some good barbecue? Come on by Southern Heritage Barbecue, 2276 Veterans Boulevard. Home cooked Southern barbecue served fast. Barbecue by the pound, mouth-watering ribs, or delicious Brunswick stew. All at Southern Heritage Barbecue. 2276 Veterans Boulevard. For those special orders, call ahead 275-4304. Southern Heritage Barbecue, Dublin.
Georgia Military College is a two-year associate's degree granting institution. We are an open admissions college. What that means is all you need to do is have a high school diploma or a GED to get accepted into GMC. We offer several associate's degree programs, including business administration, pre-nursing, psychology, criminal justice, as well as education. We offer classes during the morning, evening, and at night. We even offer some weekend classes. We offer online classes as well as in-seat classes, whatever is convenient for you and your schedule. We are located at 200 South Jefferson Street in Dublin, Georgia. If you want a great education with small class sizes, affordable tuition, we would love to see you here. Stop by to see us or give us a call. Start here, go anywhere. Georgia Military College, Dublin Campus.
Hi, I'm Perry Williamson, and we've been baking here at Williamson's Bakery since 1927. In 1965, my grandfather, Merle Williamson, hung our name on this bakery. Ever since then, people have been stopping in for the Williamson's tradition. We invite you to do the same here at 1634 Veterans Boulevard, or catch us on Facebook, or just come get you some.
Hi, I'm Tom Domney, W. Nelson Company. We're a full-service wholesaler specializing in plumbing, irrigation, and industrial products. We are committed to building long-term relationships with our customers by earning your business every day. With a staff that collectively offers more than 50 years of expertise, our team knows your industry. We're able to answer your questions and are ready to help you get the parts and equipment you need. At WDIG Nelson, our goal is long-term success of your business. We achieve that goal with a simple commitment, doing things right, one customer at a time. Our showroom is complete with the latest styles and fixtures. Stop by and see us at 507 Airport Road, or give us a call at 478-272-3585. That's WDIG Nelson.
It is an honor and a pleasure to announce two awards this evening, the Rising Star Award and the Principal's Award. There are two graduates who will receive the Rising Star Award. One of the Rising Star Awards is in memory of Betty Jo Todd. Ms. Todd is the mother of Tina Hester, who retired in 2020 from East Lawrence. The other Rising Star Award is in memory of Carrie Walker Scream. Ms. Scream was a food service worker at East Lawrence Primary, and she made history by becoming the first black female bus driver employed by Lawrence County Board of Education. Ms. Scream is the grandmother of current staff member, Ms. Charlotte Jackson White. The Rising Star Awards go to two students who have consistently performed at the top of their class, but who have over the last year significantly gained momentum and developed a focus that distinguishes them from their peers. The East Lawrence High School Rising Star Award is in memory of Ms. Betty Jo Todd and Ms. Carrie Walker Scream for the class of 2023, respectively, goes to Caitlin Kennedy and Alexis Reed. There are two graduates who will receive the Principal's Award. One is in memory of Mr. Marvin Tanner, a local farmer and lifelong Falcon who drove the bus for countless sports teams at East Lawrence High School and hardly missed a game even after he retired. The other Principal's Award is in memory of Mr. Charles E. Turner, better known as Coach T or Mr. T by his students. He began his teaching career on the East Side in 1976. He was known for his discipline, respect, resilience, work ethic, and dedication. Coach Turner served in the United States Navy and Naval Reserve, and during his tenure, Mr. Turner coached football, girls basketball, track and field. His 19-year run as the head coach of the Lady Falcons basketball team led to 302 wins. Coach Turner retired in 2006 after 32 years of service. His motto was, "You are not here by chance, but by God's choosing to fulfill a special purpose." These two awards recognize students who quietly but powerfully perform at a high level every single day. Not only are their efforts continual, they are also recognized leaders among their peers in the classroom. They're at the top of their class, and they are invested in extracurricular activities. And above all, they're kind. The 2023 East Lawrence Principal's Award in memory of Mr. Marvin Tanner and Mr. Charles Turner for the class of 2023, respectively, goes to Noah Porter and Nadrika Powell. Mr. Garnto, will you join me? Will the 2023 class of East Lawrence High School please rise? Mr. Garnto, I certify that these members of the 2023 senior class of East Lawrence High School have met all the requirements set forth by the State Board of Education, State Department of Education, and the Lawrence County Board of Education, and are certified to become graduates of East Lawrence High School.
By the authority vested in me by the State of Georgia and Lawrence County Board of Education, it is truly a privilege to declare the graduates of East Lawrence High School with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities thereunto pertaining.
Portions of this program are brought to you by State Representative Matt Hatchett, serving Lawrence County since 2011. And this year, Matt has been appointed chairman of the powerful House Appropriations Committee and has made it his mission to put more money back into the pockets of the hardworking people of Lawrence County. Matt will continue to fight for you. To the graduates in 2023, Matt Hatchett voted to give recipients of the Hope Scholarship 100% free tuition. So congratulations to the class of 2023 from your District 155 State Representative Matt Hatchett, serving the fine people of Lawrence County. Portions of this program are brought to you by Jack's on the River. We are so proud of the class of 2023, Jack's on the River, 245 Rex Miller Road in East Dublin.
As diplomas are presented, we ask that you hold your applause until the end. Also, please respect each graduate by not yelling in order for each graduate's name to be heard.
Jamie Lee Norris also received Associates of Science in General Studies from Georgia Military College. Jessica Ann Norris also received Associates of Science in General Studies from Georgia Military College. Grace McKenzie Robinson. Joshua Avery Mullis. Caitlin Grace Kennedy. Riley Grace Shepherd. Also received an Associates of Arts in General Studies from Bruton Parker College. Doreen Beverly Bass. Mason Maynor Lloyd. Alexis Darlene Hay. Let's go! Landon Wade Sims. Shauna Maria Wood. Noah Lee Porter. Nadrika Jamiko Powell. Heidi Elizabeth Avery. Liliana Irene Farmer. Alexis Dewan Judy Mae Reed. Also received an Associate of Science in General Studies from Georgia Military College. Hannah Elizabeth Meacham. Tyler Bradley Graham. Jocelyn Perellas. Rayleigh Claire Covington. Nevea Patriana Lene Lagrune Coley. Chloe Aaron Collins. Also received an Associate of Science in General Studies from Georgia Military College. Dawson James Hobbs. Haley Michelle Snellgrove. Damia Christine Gunter. Sage Ashlyn Stewart. Noah William Rozier. Tristan Baker. Mason Marie Frost. Kamarion Montez Green. Trevor Nolan Tibbetts. Caden Nicholas Chaffin. Lakely Nayla Pope. Taquan DeMonte Jackson. Addison Michaela Spires. Jamiria Camille Burrell. Roman Kaifa Coley. Tamia Janae Roberts. Marshall David Cutler. McKenna Faith McDaniel. DeAsia Charisse Thomas. Talia Vontivia Green. Tyler Malay Branham. James Camden Deal. Carlos Roberto Laborio Navidad. Joel Riley Bentley. Nicholas Roy White. Sierra McKinley Bigpen. Laura Lee Wynn. Jade Nicole Wright. Hayden Matthew Palmer. Dorian Malik Dudley. Daniel Carlton Hobbs. Nikiana Sanaya Stanley.
Kay Woods. Quintavious Jamari Adolphus. Remarian Jamar Bivens. Emily L. Brown. Shaquez Corte Brown. Kashmir Ynez Bryant. Nicholas Cole Buxton. Talia Rodnisha Bird. Tyler Jacob Kanigi. Emmanuel Cantrell Cannon. Denard Sedarius Carswell. Mackenzie J. Carter. Emma K. Cawley. Trayon Lakevious Cole. A Diamond Zaire Coney. Princessa Ruby Corona. Markel Devon Kyler. Tykeria DeAsia Kyler. Jeffrey Wilson Daniel. Haley Joe Dean. Elijah DeAndre Downing. Joshua Tex Edge. Janaya Miranda Edwards. Zakiria Danae Figaro. Lily Jade Fountain. Alexis Lynn Francis. Lamod Denarion Gibson. Jessica Addison Giles. Carlos Estuardo Lara Cepeda Graves. Allie Michelle Green. Jacob Rex Griffith. Kiara Jemaya Hall. Keontae Jamil Hall. JC Lee Harvey. Jason Luke Horton. Cameron Dalton Howard. Aaliyah Claire Huckabee. Omarion Vonquez Jackson. Darius Levante Knight. Najuan Cornell Lattimore. Lydia Grace Lukey. Takaya Nakel Mims. Damarin Keyshawn Mitchell. Tyende Brian Mitchell. Avery Kate Moon. Alex Tyler Newsom. Canyon Jace Nix. Anthony Jerome O'Neill Jr. Jacoby Raquan O'Neill. Jazlyn Keandria O'Neill. Jermaine Jerallen O'Neill. Cole Weston Page. Tegan Carlin Passmore. David Anthony Penny. Passion A Miracle Pinkston. Cage Philip Poole. Laquarius DeMartez Kushan Powell. Destiny Cheyenne Pruitt. Kyle Hunter Register Jr. Justin Paul Rich. Travion Jermonte Richards. Caleb Amir Robertson. Jacob Manning Rowland. James Dylan Roy. Marissa Jeanette Saavedra. Autumn Alexa Scott. Camden Lee Shiver. Nikita Thawanda Singleton Jr. Chase Nathaniel Smith. Jasmine Elaine Gail Smith. Pharrell Jermaine Smith. Cameron Najir Sneed. Madison Nicole Souls. Sophia Lauren Solorio. Austin Landon Spivey. Christina Antwilasia Dejanay Stanley. Colby Neil Starling. Aaliyah Adriana Steiger. Rebecca Brenda K. Tucker. Nadia Yasmin Verdugo Lopez. Devin Malik Colin Walker. Tyquavis Taquan Wilcher. Melvin Leo Wilcox. Logan Christian Wilkes. Nicholas Alexander Williams. Madeline Brianna Wilson. Jalen Tyrell Wright.
At Georgia First Bank, we understand that experience is everything, and we promise to get it right the first time, every time. Selling a mortgage loan is a big piece of the puzzle when it comes to buying a new home. At Georgia First, we have quick turnaround for approvals, usually 24 to 48 hours. And the reason for that is local decision making. Let Georgia First secure your next mortgage loan. Georgia First Bank, Soperton, Vidalia, and now in Dublin. Georgia First Bank, member FDIC, and an equal housing lender. Congratulations to the class of 2023 from Farmers State Bank. Life is filled with milestones, and Farmers State Bank would like to take this opportunity to salute all the graduates this year. Your hard work and determination is commendable, and everyone at Farmers State Bank would like to recognize the senior class of 2023. Farmers State Bank looks forward to building relationships and helping you reach the next milestone in your life. Remember, your future is as easy as FSB. Farmers State Bank, with locations in Dublin and Cadwell. Member FDIC and an equal housing lender. Quality products and installation since 1985. That's Four Seasons.
Jason services cars well at Dublin Chevrolet.
Eli sells cars well at Dublin Chevrolet.
Rob Houston sells cars well at Dublin Chevrolet.
Dylan sells cars well at Dublin Chevrolet.
We do cars well every day at Dublin Chevrolet.
As graduates of East Lawrence High School, you may now move your tassels.
As a graduate of East Lawrence High School, class of 1985, I am honored to induct this year's graduating class into the East Lawrence Alumni Association. Graduates, you are joining a distinguished group of alumni of East Lawrence High School. Remember your high school days with fond memories. You will make new friends in the future, but never forget the ones who walk with you along this journey. I encourage you to come back and support the different events at East Lawrence High School to make new memories and encourage those who will follow in your footsteps. It is with great pleasure that I now induct you, class of 2023, as members of our Alumni Association. Congratulations, graduates.
Dr. J. Lee Collins, principal of East Lawrence High School, from the 2023 senior class. We are giving the school a tree to be planted in the honor of Carlos Graves. In addition, we are presenting a $250 scholarship to be awarded to an eligible student in the 2024 graduating class who fulfills the scholarship guidelines.
Will you please stand and join us in singing the school's alma mater?
Mid the wavering pines of Georgia, neath the bright blue sky, stands our noble alma mater, East Lawrence High. When the cares of life o'ertake us, let's turn our memories back. Hail to thee, our alma mater of the gold and black.
Great job.
It is a long-standing tradition at East Lawrence High that each graduating senior present their diploma and a rose to their parents or guardians. The presentation of the diploma symbolizes the senior's gratitude for the parents or guardians' support and guidance. The yellow rose symbolizes the senior's love and respect for their parents or guardians. Tonight, a white rose has been displayed in memory of Carlos Graves. At this time, we would like to honor his memory with a moment of silence. We will now observe the rose ceremony.
Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that your soul to bleed. Some say
Graduation day is a day of change. We are leaving East Lawrence, where we have been together for 14 years. East Lawrence will no longer be a part of our daily lives. Of course, we will cope with this change, and tonight our celebrations will go a long way to helping us say goodbye properly. Tomorrow, we can look forward to the next set of changes. Life does not offer us a smooth path. Ahead will be tough times, regrets, and failures, as well as successes, rewards, and happiness. All of it is part of a journey known as life. As William Perky said, you gotta dance like there's nobody watching, love like you'll never be hurt, sing like there's nobody listening, and live like it's heaven on earth.
Will the class of 2023 please rise? I present to you the class of 2023.
Get on into Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales today and get a great deal during Dublin Auto Sales Salute to the Graduates of 2023. You'll find affordable transportation at Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales. Getting to work or school requires dependable transportation, and that's what you'll find at Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales. Bank rate financing and in-house financing available. Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales, Come see TJ, Trey, Alan, and Brent, or any of the friendly sales staff at Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales, 606 East Jackson Street in Dublin. Call us at 478-275-2010 or log on to DublinAutoSalesGA.com, where good deals and good people meet. Wayne Kemp's Dublin Auto Sales, congratulating the graduates of 2023.